Hi, today's screencast is on calculating average relative atomic mass, where we'll take a look at isotopes and the abundance of each isotope to work out the relative atomic mass. Before we do that, quick retrieval. Have a go at these, please. Pause the video. Okay, number one, what is the definition of an isotope? Well, something like atoms of the same element with a different atomic mass, or you could have said atoms of the same element with different number of neutrons. Number two, how many neutrons does hydrogen have? Well, this is hydrogen, atomic mass 1, atomic number 1. So the number of neutrons is 1, take away 1, which is 0. So hydrogen atom has 0 neutrons. Number three, how many neutrons does chlorine atom have? If it has an atomic mass of 35.5 and atomic number of 17, well, if it's chlorine 35, then it will have 18 neutrons. If it's chlorine 37, then it will have 20 neutrons. Can you have neutrons? No. Number five, who discovered the neutron? James Chadwick, around about 1930s, the neutron was discovered. Moving on. So that's the objective. Think about this one. Pause the video. What can you tell me about this atom? So pause the video here and write down as many things as you can. Okay, so let's have a look. So it's clearly the lithium atom. It's got an atomic mass of 7, atomic number 3, and that's telling me that if its atomic number is 3, it's got 3 protons. And because it's an atom is a neutral particle, if it's got 3 protons, it will also have 3 electrons. And to work out the number of neutrons, it's 7 take away 3, which is 4 neutrons. Just following on from that, 3 electrons, the way they will be arranged, there will be 2 in the first shell, 1 in the outer shell, and that 1 tells you that it's in group 1 of the periodic table. It also, if you look at this, shell number 1, shell number 2, so 2 shells means it's in period number 2 of the periodic table. Okay, moving on then. What is the definition of isotopes? And what's the difference between these two elements? So, pause the video here and have a look at these two questions. Okay. So we've already said this. What's the definition of isotopes? We've said it's the atoms of the same element with different number of neutrons, or atoms of the same element with different atomic mass. And the second, what's the difference between these two elements? Well, that's got 17 electrons. This one's got 17 electrons. This one's got 17 protons. This one's got 17 protons. However, 18 neutrons here, but 20 neutrons here. So the difference is, it's the number of neutrons. In other words, these two are isotopes. Atoms of the same element, but they have different number of neutrons. This one's got 18, and this one's got 20. So these are both isotopes. We'll move on. Nearly all of the elements in the periodic table have isotopes, but for most of them, the vast majority of atoms are one particular isotope. And so the average mass is always close to a whole number. Hydrogen has 3 isotopes. However, 99.98% of all hydrogen is hydrogen 1. So the average atomic mass is close to 1. So it makes to make no difference. And the 3 isotopes of hydrogen, you've got deuterium, and you've got tritium, and you can clearly see that. Like we said before, the hydrogen, 99.98% of hydrogen, which is this one, there is no nucleus. This hydrogen, there's one nucleus, one proton. Tritium has two neutrons and one proton. Moving on. Here's a question for you. Calculating the average relative atomic mass. Now, in the exam, they will give you the abundance of each element. 25% is chlorine 37, 75% is chlorine 35. So, it will either say calculate the relative atomic mass, or it will say, why do you think the mass number of chlorine is 35.5 on the periodic table? So, you need to do a simple calculation where you'll do 75% of chlorine is 35. So you'll do 35 times 75%, which is 0.75. And that'll give you an answer. 25% is chlorine 37. So you'll do 37 times 25%, which is 0.25. And you'll add both answers. And you should get 35.5. So there we go. So chlorine 35 has an abundance of 75%. Chlorine 37 has an abundance of 25%, and because it's percentage, you divide by 100, and there's your answer. So that's another way of doing it. So you can either do it this way, or you can do it this way. Moving on. The periodic table states that the relative atomic mass of boron is 11. Boron has two naturally occurring isotopes. 80% is boron 11, 20% is boron 10. So calculate the atomic mass of boron. Pause the video here and have a go, please. Okay, so looking at this, so boron 11, 80% of this, so 11 times 80%, which is 0.8, that'll give you an answer. And boron 10, there's 20% of this, so it's 10 times 20%, which is 0.2. And if you add the both answers, you should get 11. The answer is actually that which has been rounded up to 11. Okay. Here's a question for you today. Have a look at this one, the extension. Lead is 1.4% 204, 24% 206, 22% 207, and 52% 208. What's the average relative atomic mass, and show you full working out? So pause the video here and have a go at this. This will be definitely worth around 3 marks, maybe even 4. Okay, so the answer you should have got is there. So there's a 1.4% of 204, there's 24% of 206, there's 22% of 207, there's 52% of 208. You divided by, because it's percentage, you divide by 100, and there's your answer. Here's something for you to do. Use the computer to find the abundance of isotopes of other elements. Do your own research, you can do that. And then from that, it's advisable that you create your own questions, because that will make you think, and that's where learning takes place. And that's the end of this screencast.